here on Fresh Outlook. Lots to talk about this week. Fresh Outlook's money guy, Paul Oster, joins us now, along with political psychologist Dr. Bart Rossi. And we're talking about all the turmoil around the world. Are we going to see some turmoil on Wall Street? And Paul, nice to see you. That is the question and the topic for right now. Do you think we closed out August on a pretty good note? But do you think we're going to see some jitters and some
I do. You know, the S&P is in record-breaking territory now. But again, I've said it numerous times on the show, be careful what we wished for. We have this global economy now, so we're all tied together. And, you know, the tensions in Ukraine mount every day. Who knows what Mr. Putin is really thinking? But there are now tanks and boots on the ground. They've probably been there longer than we actually know. But those types of things are going to continue to cause hiccups in our economy for sure.
And of course, this week, as you mentioned, Ukraine called for full membership in NATO on Friday.
Sure they did. A little, to me, you know, I would make them wait a little bit. I mean, they've had the opportunity to come into NATO. Of course they want in now because they want the benefits associated with being a member of NATO. But, you know, for us to allow them to come in to kind of do that at this point, I agree with it, but I don't agree with it.
So give me a prediction, since you're our money guy here. What do you think is going to happen in the next month, in the next 2 months? I mean, obviously, we don't know what's going to happen around the world, but it does not look like it's going to be stable.
It is, and that's unfortunate, because our economy is kind of chugging along, you know, in the right direction. But again, at the end of the day, when you look at things, we're allocating more and more resources again. You know, what's going to happen in Syria? Are we going to, you know, expand the airstrikes? All of those types of things are going to have a negative impact on our economy.
Well, we're certainly going to be watching. And of course, on Friday also, we heard from the UK, they've raised their terror alert. And there's supposedly, you know, a little bit higher alerts here in the US as well.
David Cameron's right. I mean, they should raise the terror alert and the concern. And Obama's just playing golf. Oh, well, whatever, and really very lackadaisical. And that's why Ed Henry asked, do you have a plan? There's not even a plan. So I think we should follow the UK's example.
Well,
the only thing
I got to say, I wish they would quit saying on the news that Obama doesn't have a plan. And
but he doesn't.
Well, no, Frank Luntz jumping out of his skin, because he has so many people contributing to what he says. And for them to come up with, we have no strategy, I could have written that.
But would you? Well, that's the thing. Would you write it? Of course you would not write it. I mean,
and
you
then
know,
for them
greed.
To continue to speak about it is just crazy.
Well, I just take a little different view of that. I don't think the optics were great. What was said was great. However, I think the president is trying to be deliberate, thoughtful, and come up with a plan and a strategy and not get into cowboy diplomacy, which we've seen in the recent
past.
That's
the first time for everything.
We're not debating politics right now. We're going to debate. We're going to talk about business. This is our business segment. Hey, you guys want to go get a
burger? Hey, he started it.
Yeah. You guys want to go get a burger? How about that? Well, as you probably all know, Burger King is moving to Canada, but is it a raw deal for American taxpayers? If you didn't hear, fast food chain announced this week plans to buy Canadian coffee and donut chain Tim Hortons for about $11 billion. Now, by moving abroad, can they secure lower tax rates? Again, we're going to turn over to Paul.
It's called inversion. So big companies have been doing it forever. We spoke about it on the show not too long ago, and I don't blame Burger King for doing it.
But it's supposed to be a great deal for them.
Oh, it's a great deal. But for them to say that's not the reason why they're doing it, come on.
Lie.
Everybody knows that's why you're doing it. The parent company is going to be housed in Canada so they can enjoy lower tax breaks. There's a couple of things that they do. I'll tell you one of the things that they're going to do. They're going to loan. The parent company is going to loan its U.S. subsidiaries millions and millions of dollars, and then they don't pay taxes on the interest on those loans. It's just another trick.
What about, though, and you know, a lot of people are saying, is this unpatriotic? We'll start with you, Dr. Rossi.
Well, it's manipulative, so therefore unpatriotic, yes, for sure. And I think a lot of people object to it. I think Warren Buffett, as much as I like him, I don't think he looks good on this one either.
No.
And I think that the optics don't look right on this whole situation. And I think there's going to be a backlash against Burger King for this deal, although I agree with Paul, it certainly is the right deal for them.
And well, from a monetary standpoint, sure.
Well, but the bigger problem is the high corporate taxes. That's the bigger problem. Of course, we need to lower that. But for them to leave the cut and run, I'm disappointed. No more Burger King for me.
Well, and you're not the only one. A couple of senators have also called for a ban. The Ohio senator said, I'm boycotting Burger King.
Me too.
Anybody else boycotting Burger King?
I don't like it.
I don't have to boycott it because I'm not a fan of it in the first place. But I think they've done. Unfortunately, they do lots of studies about psychology behind what's going to happen. And Didi may be a person. Lots of people say that's it. I'm done. But at the end of the day, when they're driving through a rest area and they need a burger, they might go to
I'm done. No Burger King for me. You can count on that.
And let's just talk about how big they are. There are 7,000 Burger Kings here in the U.S. There are 18,000. Once this deal goes through, they'll have 18,000 restaurants in 100 countries. So,
well, you know what? I think Paul has a point here, except that this industry is not doing well. The hamburger industry is not doing well. Panera Breads and Chipotle's and all of these other higher-end food products are doing much better. So I don't think the timing is very good for this situation.
Well,
they're also starting to add healthier menus, though.
Healthier, yeah.
Well, McDonald's is doing very badly. I mean, they're really tanking because their food, if you're a healthy eater, there's nothing to eat. Mia, you're a healthy eater. Do you eat at McDonald's ever?
Probably
negative.
Once a year, if I have to.
A filet o fish. Is that fish?
Yeah.
Not sure.
Fish product. Yeah.
All right. Well, we're going to be watching that one as well, but certainly a lot of money on the table on that one, so to speak, the dinner table, that is. All right. Is the Comcast-Time Warner merger consumer-friendly? Now, many are saying no because it will give unmatched power and control to one media company. We'll start with you on that one, Didi.
Yeah, I got to say, we're creeping towards a monopoly, it seems. It seems to be awfully big. So you want there to be a free market, but you want there to be a market. So, yeah, I'm sort of suspect of that being a good thing.
And I think the FCC had something like 93 questions on this. I was reading through them about this merger.
Right.
Not sure if you gentlemen heard this, but Glenn Beck also has been boycotting this. A couple of folks are boycotting this as well.
Now, that's conservatives are doing it. That's not good.
But saying that it's too left-leaning, so kind of an interesting twist on that as well. But do you think this is too big?
I think it's too big. I think Didi has a great point. The psychology of not having competition means there is no competition, and therefore it's a monopoly. I don't know about it being leftist, though. I think it's just something that's too big and too overwhelming.
And Glenn Beck's head, he's thinking big government, big business, too big, too powerful.
And of course, several governors, Cuomo in New York is demanding to see what happens. And of course, if you weren't in New York this week, you, Didi, know about the shutdown. Of course, I think they lost the internet for something like 10 hours. That couldn't have come at a worse time for this merger.
Yep. And again, Didi said it best. It is a monopoly. You had the third company that was looking to buy into Time Warner before Comcast, and they backed out of the deal. They were pushed back a little bit by Comcast. And you know what Comcast said? We'll give you X amount, a percentage of our company, so then when we buy in, now you've created an even larger monopoly. You'll have three of the largest media companies out there merging into one.
So what specifically should the politicians be asking and demanding right now?
Well, look at the restrictions, look at the law. I mean, and let's follow it for once. I mean, let's really get into the nitty-gritty because, we're not supposed to have monopolies in this country. We don't want it to be too big, too powerful.
Well, the point that Didi makes is a good one, but it involves government and government laws and regulations that are reasonable. And in this case, I think they're going beyond what is reasonable. There are some laws out there that make sense and prevent this type of a monopoly.
Well, in terms of business and for the average person, Paul, could this benefit the consumer?
No.
No. They say they're doing it so they're more competitive, but who are they competing against after this merger?
So
no
prices
one.
Prices conceivably could go up for the consumer.
They'll be able to do whatever they want because we won't have as many choices.
It's a dictatorship, never a good thing.
It's not good for the consumer at all.
No.
Mayor de Blasio, again, I don't think it's a mayoral position to come in and weigh in on it like that, because we have the governing bodies. The FCC should say too big, monopoly, stamp it. And
well, I think he was also weighing in, as was Cuomo, because of the outage this week. I think that was on Friday, and I think I think it really does hurt the cause for this merger.
Definitely.
Yeah, but I think the mayor should weigh in. I think the mayor is the mayor of the city, and he has a right to say something about it.
He had a million plus people in the city losing.
And when now you have the internet is such an integral part of education. If you're a child at home and you don't have access to the internet, you're at a big disadvantage.
Well, look at all the businesses that lost money for the whole day.
And you know, it's hundreds of dollars a month just to have basic cable, and that's crazy, and it could actually go higher now.
Ooh, that's not good business news. All right, well, we do also want to talk about something else. Those Google drones landing in a slightly different atmosphere. Did you hear this story? It didn't start off as a very favorable product, I guess you would say, but now all of a sudden it's taken on a different atmosphere, if we want to say.
Yeah.
How about that little play on words there?
Well, again, like everything, we're way behind the technology. So the technology is exploding. They're becoming more and more popular. The prices are dropping. The average person has a drone now. Who doesn't have a drone?
Well, who doesn't have a drone? Dee Dee, do you have a drone?
I'm going to go out and get one now. And now you shame me into it. I'm going to go buy
Dr. Burke, do you have a drone?
I don't have a drone yet. I'm not thinking that way.
Do you think it's going to come down to that?
I don't think it becomes a viable means of distribution, distributing anything. You're talking about airspace that's already, you know, kind of shaky as it is.
A little shaky here in the New Jersey, New York area.
Yeah, mm-hmm. And now you'll have commercial drones competing with personal,
I don't know. Drones. I think it could be a thing. I really do. I think it could maybe take on. It's just hard to tell.
It could be until one of them crashes in the middle of I-95 during rush hour.
And it will.
You know, there's lots of...
I wonder, how do you regulate something like this?
Well, that's
Where does that come in? How do you actually?
Well, like
put some
Paul said, it's new.
On?
We don't know what's going to happen. But there's an interest in it. Yeah. There's a fear
about it. But there's interest. I would say there's a exactly, Dee Dee. There's a fear
and
there's an interest.
You know, Amazon was the one who put it out there, and it was almost a advertising stunt when they talked about, you know, they could deliver packages in under an hour, and someone said, well, maybe we could make that a reality.
All right, we're going to take a short break. We also do want to mention in this business segment, India's economy got a jolt this week, up nearly 6%. Interesting business news there. All right, keep it here to Fresh Outlook, especially if you have kids or you happen to be one. We're heading back to school in our next segment and have plenty of tips for parents and teachers when we return.